you've heard of hybrid cars, right? But have you heard of hybrid investments? Now, to drive home this information, we have Jim Lineweaver all geared up to explain that these hybrid investments could be fueling your portfolio. Jim's a financial planner with the Lineweaver Financial Group. Tongue twister today. How you doing, Jim?
Good. How about yourself?
Jim, I'm good. There are two parts to a hybrid investment. Some characteristics of stocks and some of bonds, if I understand correctly. How does that work?
Well, what ends up happening is a hybrid can basically be a division of the two. So you could have an income-producing instrument like a bond, but it might float a little bit like an equity over time with some appreciation. Okay, so those are called preferreds.
Now, you mentioned bonds. Tell us just a little background on bonds and how those work.
Sure. Bonds are what's called fixed income investments. And what happens is a company's going to issue debt, and then that buyer of that bond will get income off that bond for a certain period of time. And then at maturity, if you hold it to maturity, you're going to get all your principal back. So they're fixed income. They can be kind of boring. There's nothing sensational about them. But they've been really kind of steady Eddie.
All right. And that's been happening. They've been steady.
They have. As a matter of fact, if you look at some of the statistics over the last 10 years, the market measured by the S&P 500 has dropped on average 3.4% per year. And the actual growth through bonds have actually averaged 5.6% per year in the same period of time. So recognize that, you know, for some more stable things, or people, especially in retirement, that want something a little more stable, they can rely on for income, it can provide some very good benefits.
But with bonds, don't we have to worry about interest rates?
You do. You have to be very careful with interest rates, because as interest rates go up, bonds principal can go down. Now, you can get around that if you hold the bond to maturity. You don't have to worry about the interest rate fluctuations. But there are a lot of different types of bonds, too, that you can look at.
What are they?
There's corporate bonds that you can look at, issued by major corporations, your Home Depot, your GEs of the world. You also have municipal bonds that can be tax-free. So those taxpayers that are in a high-income tax bracket, if they buy like an Ohio bond, they can actually get federal and state tax-free income off that so that they don't have to pay any income tax on that whatsoever.
All right, so we've been focusing a lot on bonds now. Get back to hybrids. How does a hybrid work?
Okay, hybrid is called a preferred stock, and it's a way for a company to raise money as well. But what'll happen is they're going to have a yield like a bond, so maybe it's going to yield in that 5, 6, 7% range, but then the underlying price is going to fluctuate more like a security. So if you want to sell it throughout the day or at any time you can, you don't have to hold it to a certain maturity, and it can provide some very good liquidity while also providing yield at the same time.
When you say you can sell up preferred stock anytime, you can't sell a bond at any time?
You could, but what ends up happening is a lot of people get involved in bond mutual funds. There's not a lot of people that buy the individual bonds. So if you're buying an individual bond, you can. The mutual fund would have to kind of close at the end of the day. But see, if you did try to hold the bond or sell it intraday, you could have a gain or a loss depending on how that bond is trading at that time. Okay, so you do have to be careful with that. So when you're looking at a preferred stock, yes, you can trade it intraday. It could have a gain or loss too, but it's for those people that want some appreciation but yet not the exposure of the equity market, they can actually get a hybrid and have the best of both worlds.
And where do we go to find a hybrid? I mean, I know where you find a hybrid car. You go to the car store.
Call a good financial advisor. They should be able to take care of it. But they are listed on the stock exchanges.
Great. Thank you very much, Jim. Good information, and something that I'm not sure a lot of people understand or know about, hybrid preferred stocks.
Good investment.
Just like your car, you need to keep an eye on what's fueling your portfolio and occasionally take it in for a tune-up so it runs at maximum efficiency. For a complete diagnostic, give Jim a call. His number's next.
For more information, call the Lineweaver Financial Group at 1-888-313-4009 or log on to www.lineweaver.net. Next, simple steps to stop stiffness. But first, only two states can toast to your health with an official state beverage. One is Florida, where orange juice squeezed out the competition. Can you name the other shippable state? We'll spill out the answer when we return.